Good morning, children. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I will teach Computer Chapter 3 from page number 43 to 45. Please open your book to page 43. Take a pencil in your hand. Watch the video. Follow my explanation and try to understand. Today we will read and at the same time I will show you practically the changes that takes place. Page 43, at the bottom of the page you see the red color heading deleting text. So we will start from that part. To delete a character, press either the delete key or the backspace key. So let me show you. This is the delete key and this is the backspace key. So if you want to remove anything from the text in MS Word Office, you have to use these two keys, any one of these two keys, delete key or backspace key. So, please bracket the line in your book to delete from there to backspace key and underline the word delete and backspace which you have to prepare for your inside short question answers. Next, delete key removes the character to the right of the cursor. So, if you want to remove anything to the right of the cursor, then you have to use which key? Delete key. So please bracket this line from the delete key to cursor and underline the word right. So again, the lines that I am telling you to bracket and underline particular words, you have to prepare this as important information which may come as short questions like fill in the blanks, true, false, name the following, math in the matching and so. Okay. So, just now we have gathered, we have learned the information that delete key removes the character to the right of the cursor. Now, you will all open MS Word. From where to open that one? See? This is the start button of your computer. Click over there and then take this arrow up to Microsoft Office Word. Click on it and open. Okay, I've already opened. So now I want to delete a character and by pressing the delete key, I will remove the character to the right of the cursor. So let me press the cursor here. See, can you all see, children, the cursor? This is the blinking light, blinking line, black color line. That is called the cursor. So I have placed the cursor after the comma. The comma is there after the word tab. And the cursor is blinking over there and I will press delete key. Which key? Delete key. See, this is the delete key. I am pressing and you all see the change. See, the characters are getting removed. Which side? Right side. Okay, if I press, then in the right of the cursor, the characters will be removed. Children, please turn to next page, page 44 of your book. See, it is written backspace key. The backspace key removes the character to the left of the cursor. So now it is said about which key? Backspace key. So which one is the backspace key? This is the backspace key Say for example, you see on computer screen, the cursor is after the comma again. After the word tab, there is comma, and then the cursor is blinking over there. And I will now press which key? Backspace key. And see what changes occur. See, when I'm pressing backspace key, characters to the left of the cursor are getting removed. Okay. Next information in your book, you see, have you all bracketed the portion from the backspace key to the cursor position? You bracket that and underline backspace key and underline the word left. After doing that, you shift, move to the next line. To delete a block of text, select the text and then press the delete key or the backspace key. If I want to remove the entire block or paragraph, full paragraph or full block, if I want to delete, then how can I do that? I have to select it. Say for example, this is the first paragraph and I want to delete the first paragraph. So for that, I have to select it. How can I select? By dragging, I can select. See, I have selected. The sky blue highlighter has come, so it means I have selected. And then anyone, by pressing any key, delete key or backspace key, any key, I can just delete it. See, I am pressing backspace key, you see. See, the paragraph is removed. So if I want to remove a block, full block, then I have to select the full portion and then press anyone, delete key or backspace key. I have shown you with backspace key. You can do the same by using delete key as well. Now let us move to the next topic on page 44, that is copying and moving text. Sometimes we need to repeat some text at more than one location. Suppose I have composed one letter in MS Office Word. Will I write that same letter again and again in 3-4 other separate documents? Definitely not. We all know that computer reduces our work and helps us to work in a faster way. So definitely I will not type it again and again. Rather, I will just make copy of it and paste in other locations. So for that we have to use copying text and moving text options. See the heading copying text. Please bracket the first sentence. The copy command creates a duplicate copy of the original text. So from the copy to original text, you please bracket and underline copy command and underline the word duplicate. So this copy command helps us to make duplicate copies of the original one. As you move to a Xerox shop, what you do? You can make photocopy of the same document. As many copies as you want, you can get Xerox copies, and Xerox copies are exactly the same of the original one, duplicate copies. Similarly, here also you can make duplicate copies. Then you have the paste command, which helps you to insert the text which you have copied at some new location. So please, from paste command to new location, please bracket, underline paste command and underline word insert. Underline insert and paste command. Again, this you have to prepare for your short inside questions. Now there are certain steps how to make copy and paste. First, what we need, I am reading, explaining you. You see your book and watch my video. First is to select. So for making any change in computer, we need to select. See, I am placing the cursor and then dragging it and selecting this portion. So my first portion is, first paragraph is selected. Then under home tab, see children, can you all see, this is the home tab
I am placing the arrow. This is the home tab. Under home tab, these three options you will get. The middle one is the copy option. See, when I am putting this arrow here, then it is the word in the dialog box, it is shown the word copy, and in bracket the shortcut key is also given, Control plus C. So I have selected the portion and now I am copying it. And now I will show you how to paste it in a new location. At the end of the third paragraph, see, I placed the cursor there and I just want to copy it over there. When the cursor is placed, then from your mouse, you make a right click. Several options will come, and under that, you will find in the dialog box the option paste. When you take this arrow up, place it over paste and click it. When you do that, you see the first paragraph is now copied again. See, this first paragraph on the insert tab, from there to the last line of the first paragraph, document look is now again pasted at the end of the document. Because I have copied it and pasted it. Another way of doing it is by using the shortcut keys. How can I do that? Suppose these three, four words. These three, four words I am selecting. And I want these three, four words to be copied by using the shortcut keys. First you have to select by dragging, and then from your keyboard, this is the control and this is C. You have to press these two together, and when I am pressing this, it is first getting copied. Control and C together you press, then you bring it here and then press Control and V. Sorry. See, this portion I have selected and I will use Control plus C for copy. This portion I have selected by dragging. Now Control plus C together I will press. Then here Control plus V. See, the same thing is copied. So I have to press these two things together to copy. Next, on page 45 you see the heading moving text. Here we will learn how to use the cut command. The cut command is used to remove the text from its original location. In copy command, we have just made duplicate copies of the original. But in the cut command, we will absolutely remove the text from its original and copy it. So let me first select. This is what I have selected. Then I will go to under home tab. I will go to cut command. This is the scissor. Use. Then place the cursor here. Again click. Again use this paste. See, it is pasted. Under home tab you will get these options and then paste it. We can do this by using the shortcut keys. On page 45 you see in the InShot box, you have the three shortcut keys, Control plus C for copy, Control plus X for cut, Control plus V for paste. You have to learn this. And the portions that I said, please bracket and underline those words which you have to prepare for your short question answers. From under moving text, you bracket the line from the cut command to location and underline
cut command and remove. Children, please follow the explanation, watch it and read the pages from 43 to 45 thoroughly. And in my next video, I will start from page 46.